छन रा बाकी कहा सबै छन जाति यहाँ कोई छन रा बाकी कहा सबै छन जाति यहाँ गरे का मिले सबै एउटे हो सबको रहर बनाओ यो हाम्रो सहर
एउटे हो सबको रहर बनाओ यो हाम्रो सहर
हाम्रो विराट नगर हाम्रो आउँदो दिनमा
क्लासिफिकेशन अफ अर्गानिजम अथवा सम्पूर्ण जीव जन्तुको क्लासिफिकेसन्सहरू यिनीहरूको विभाजनहरू वी हेभ अलरेडी टक्ड अ लट अबाउट द क्लासिफिकेसन अफ अर्ग्यानिजम्स अन द बेसिस अफ देयर लाइफ स्प्यान अन द बेसिस अफ देयर हेबिटेट एन्ड अन द बेसिस अफ देयर ब्याकबोन एन्ड Recently, in previous class, we were studying about the classification of invertebrate animals. Let me recall you. We were studying about the classification of animals, and in previous class, I taught you about the classification of animal on the basis of backbone. So, on the basis of backbone, we can classify animals into two categories, vertebrates and invertebrates. And in previous class, we studied some of the animals, some of the phylums that belongs to invertebrate animals. Let's recall those all the phylums of invertebrate animals with their special characteristics. Please, you can see on your screen all those invertebrate animals, means those animals that do not have backbone, can be classified into 9 phylums. First, protozoa. Second, porifera. Third, Coelenterata. Fourth, Platyhelminthes. Fifth, Nemahelminthes. Sixth, Annelida. Seven, Arthropoda. Eight, Mollusca. And 9, Echinodermata. And in previous class, I taught you about some of the general characteristics of protozoa. Let me recall it very quickly. The general characteristics of protozoa are, first, they are unicellular and microscopic animal, means they are very tiny animals and we need to use microscope to observe them. Second is, they move by the means of some special locomotory organs like pseudopodia, flagellum or cilia. Another special and general characteristic of those protozoans are they respire through their body surface. As we know that they are unicellular animals and their body is made up of single cell. So they don't have any special organ for respiration. That's why they respire through their general body surface. Next one, general characteristic of this phylum is they reproduce by cell division. Examples, amoeba, paramecium, and many more. Then we saw some pictures of protozoans. Then porifera, those animals that have pores on their body, they are called poriferans or porifera. And general characteristics of porifera are they are found in water, means they are completely aquatic. Next, their body contains numerous pores, many pores called ostia. Ostia are small pores but many in number. And they have a single large pore that we call osculum. Next, they remain attached to their substratum, means they get attached with some wood or stone in water. They do not move freely. Next one, they are multicellular animal. Examples, silicon, sponges, and monomer. You can see some pictures of porifera or the animals that belongs to porifera phylum. Next, Colentrata. And the general characteristics of these Colentrata are they have large hollow body cavity called colentron, and they have a stinging cell, means if we touch those colentrons, we will have some burning sensation in our body. They are diploblastic animal, means they have two layers of skin. Diploblastic vaneko, skin ko duita layer. Next one, they reproduce by sexual and asexual method. For an example, hydra, jellyfish, and many more. You can see some pictures of hydra and jellyfish. They belong to Colentrata. Now, next phylum of invertebrate animal is Platyhelminthes, means those animal whose body is flat like leaf. Jasko body part jasto patalo ra flat huncha. Testo animals lai hamle Platyhelminthes bhanchau. General characteristic of this Platyhelminthes are their body is leaf like flat, part jasto ekdam chepto ra patalo huncha. Their head is provided with hooks and suckers. Generally, these all Platyhelminthes are parasites. They suck the blood or they obtain their nutrition from other organism. So to obtain their nutrition, they have hooks and suckers. With the help of hooks, they get attached with the host organism, and with the help of sucker, they absorb nutrition from their host organism. Next one is they are triploblastic animal, means they have three layers of skin on their body: ectoderm, mesoderm, and endoderm. These are the three layers of triploblastic animal. Again, I repeat the name of these three layers: exoderm, mesoderm, and endoderm. Exoderm, outermost layer; mesoderm, middle layer; and endoderm, innermost layer. So they all have these three layers, so they are called triploblastic animal, and they are hermaphrodite. I explained you this word hermaphrodite in last previous class. Again, I repeat, hermaphrodite means those animals that have both sexes, means male and female in single body. Jun organism ko body ma duitai kisim ko linga paincha, stri linga pani ra pulinga pani, that has both the sexes, male and female in single body. Such animals, such organisms are called hermaphrodites, and most of these Platyhelminthes are hermaphrodites. Next, examples of these Platyhelminthes are tapeworm, planaria. You can see some pictures of tapeworm and planaria over there on your screen. Now let's go on next phylum of invertebrate animal, that is Nemahelminthes. Here, nematodes means thread and helminthes means worm, means those worm or those organisms whose body is thread-like structure. They are called Nemahelminthes. General characteristic of these Nemahelminthes are their body is cylindrical and unsegmented. They don't have any segments in their body. Yes, they have very plain and smooth body. Their body is bilaterally symmetrical. What does this bilaterally symmetrical mean? Bilaterally symmetrical body means when we cut the organisms. Yes, such organisms whose body is bilaterally symmetrical, whatever organs of their body are in left part, it will be also there in right part. Matlab, testo organisms just like beach bata hamile equal half ma divide garna sakchau katera jun daya patiko bhag ra baya patiko bhag ma same organs haru auna sakcha divided garna sakchau testo animals lai hamile bilaterally symmetrical bhanchau. Again, I repeat, dear student, bilaterally symmetrical organisms means those organisms whose body can be divided equally into two equal half, left half and right half. Next, they are unisexual. They are not hermaphrodites. They are unisexual, means male Nemahelminthes and female Helminthes are separated. We don't find both types of sexes in same body. Their sexes are different. Male Nemahelminthes and female Nemahelminthes. And the most important characteristic of this Nemahelminthes is that they are mostly parasites. Parasites means those organisms that depends on other organisms for their nutrition. They suck the blood. They suck the nutrition. They obtain their nutrition from other organisms. Such organisms are called parasites. For an example, Ascaris, pinworm, yes, and such types of worms, Nemahelminthes, are generally found in our stomach due to unhygienic food. Now, let's see the pictures of some Nemahelminthes. Here we have a diagram, a picture of Ascaris over there. Now, Annelida is there. Here, Annelida means those organisms that has little ring-shaped body. Such organisms are called Annelida, and their general characteristics are they have cylindrical, segmented and elongated body. They have segmented and elongated body. Their body can be stretched and they have ring-like segments in their body. Second, their locomotory organ are called seti or parapodia. They have very special locomotory organ. And the name of those locomotory organ are seti or parapodia. And next characteristic of these annelidans are their excretory organ are called nephridia. They have very special excretory organ to throw out the waste product of their body, and those excretory organs are called nephridia. For an example, earthworm and leech. You might have seen these pictures, these organisms in your surrounding. The first one is of earthworm and second one is of leech. Let's go on the next phylum, that is Arthropoda. Here, The word arthropoda is made up of two words. Arthros means jointed and podos means foot. Means those animals that have joint leg are called arthropoda. General characteristics of these arthropoda are, first, their body is divided into three parts. That means their body is divided into head, thorax, and abdomen. All the arthropodans' body, most of, let's not call all, most of these arthropodans' body is divided into three main parts: head part, thorax part, and abdomen part. With the head part, they see, they feel. With thoracic part, they perform different types of metabolic activities such as respiration. And with abdominal part, again they perform some other type of metabolic activities such like digestion and excretion. Next, general characteristic of these arthropodans are they have three pairs of leg and a pair of wings. Most of these arthropodans have three pairs of joint leg and a pair of wings. But it is not necessary all the arthropodans have three pairs of leg and a pair of wings. Some arthropodans, even they don't have wings, or they have many joint leg. Next is their body is covered with exoskeleton. Exoskeleton means the skeleton which is present outside the body. Generally, we human beings have endoskeleton, means our skeleton part, bony part of our body is covered with muscles. Such skeleton is called endoskeleton. But these arthropodans have exoskeleton. Next one characteristic of these organisms are they have compound eye. Yes, and have feelers in their head. They have feelers with the help of which they feel, they sense their surrounding. Example, butterfly, ant, and many types of insects that we can see in our surrounding. You can see in picture that there are so many examples of arthropoda. Some of them have wings, some of them they don't have wings. Some of them have three pairs of joint leg, some of them have many legs. Now let's go on the next classification of invertebrate animal, that is mollusca. Here the word mollusca means very soft and delicate. Means all those organisms, their body is very soft, made up of muscles, are mollusca. Let's study about their general characteristics. Their body is covered with calcareous shell. Means inside the calcareous shell, a shell made up of calcium, inside the shell, which is made up of calcium, they have a muscular body. Yes, soft and delicate muscular body. Next, their head bears mouth, tentacles, and sense organ. Next, they have well-developed organ system, means all the organ systems of these phylum are very well developed. They have well developed sense organ, they have well developed digestive system, they have well developed respiratory system. Yes. And next characteristic of this phylum is their body is asymmetrical. Asymmetrical means we can't divide their body into two equal halves. If we cut them from the middle, we will not get two equal body parts of these organisms. Such organisms, one body is called asymmetrical. Example, snail, octopus, and many more. You can see some diagrams, some pictures of mollusca over there on the screen. You might have seen such organisms in your surrounding, in books and somewhere else. Now, let's go on the last phylum of invertebrate, that is Echinodermata. Here, Echinodermata is also made up of two words. Echinos means spiny and dermata means skin. Those organisms whose body, whose skin consists of spiny shaped part. Yes, very sharp spiny surface are found on the body surface of organisms. Such organisms are called Echinodermata. Let's study the general characteristics of these Echinodermata. Their body is covered with spiny skin. Yes, made up of calcareous cell. Yes, their bodies have hard spiny skin made up of calcium. Next, their body looks like a star. Star, you know? Yes. The shape of such Echinodermata or the organisms that belongs to Echinodermata have star-shaped body. Next, they do not have a distinct head. If we try to find the head of those Echinodermata, we will not be able to distinguish their head very easily. Next, they are unisexual and reproduce by sexual method. And examples are starfish, sea urchin, and many more. I'm going to show you some pictures of Echinodermata. You can see over there starfish, sea urchin, and many more examples of Echinodermata. So, dear students, these were the phylums that belongs to invertebrate animals. So, how many phylums of invertebrate animals are there? Yes, 9 phylums. Now, for your test, let's have a quick test within a 1 minute. Please see on the screen, I have given you some of the organisms. Can you classify or identify those organisms with their special characteristics? Let's classify and identify those organisms very quickly. First one is lotus. Tell me one special characteristic of this organism. Good. They are aquatic plants. Very nice. Next, mango tree. Please tell me one special character. Very good. They are terrestrial plant and they have woody trunk. Nice. Next one is cactus. Can you tell me one special characteristic of this organism? Yes, they are xerophytes. They grow in desert area. Next one, mushroom. Please tell me one special characteristic of this organism. Yes, of course. They are found in moist and damp places. Pine. Yes, of course. They are found in hilly areas. Rahu. It is not plant, it is animal. You got any idea? Yes, it is aquatic animal, a kind of fish. They breathe through gills. Frog. Yes, very good. Frog also lives in water, but they are secondary aquatic animal. Lion, can you tell me one specific characteristic of this animal? Yes, they are cursorial animal, terrestrial and cursorial animal. Cobra, they are fossorial animals. So likewise, you can classify rest other and many more organisms that you can see around your area. I hope now you all students can classify plants and animals on the basis of different categories. Thank you very much for listening me. Enjoy your day. Have a nice day. Thank you very much.